Oh my God, lads. Up to the tune.
Oh no, why did I do it? Why did I say it last week? I'm sorry, it's my fault. It's my fault.
Kingston Park, a dark and ominous stormy night. We looked over at our opposition, the doughty men of the tune, draped in black like the night's watch, a feral glint in their eyes, and you just knew it was on.
Oh,
thing is, though, I thought we prepared really well. Like, you know, when you're in a warm-up, you feel that je ne sais quoi, you know, that zeal.
Sometimes the worst.
Yeah, and you're like, we're ready, we're woofing, we're good to go. Next minute, yeah, we were the nails and they were the hammers for a large majority of the game. I thought George McGuigan, yeah, he was nightmare canny. He was like, you know, like Grimmer Wormtongue with Theoden when he's like whispering into his ear. He's like that with Luke Pearce around scrum time, like very canny operator, class in the contact, like chop suing everything, left, right, and rhubarb. He's like that. He was the beating heart of that performance for me, for them. But yeah, they were on point, and we were off, and that's what happens in the Premier. You can't really have an off day.
And is that why you were late for the podcast again today?
Yes,
the schedule. I had to get in there.
Yeah.
Sorry, I couldn't help myself. Why were you late? Why were you late? Tell us, because has Pat lost his head?
There was a reaction. I wouldn't say he lost his head, but there was a healthy reaction to a disappointing performance. And yeah, that's rugby, gentlemen, isn't it? Yeah. So therefore, the schedule went a bit over.
You didn't stick around then afterwards, Max.
Oh, unfortunately not that. I don't want to put it out there, but you know that thing that Schalk said on the other Skulk? Wait.
Oh, we've taken some abuse for that, by the way.
Yeah.
Schalk, isn't it?
It's not Schalk, it's Skulk.
Skulk. And you
know,
Mark,
Skulk.
Put this in there. Don't edit this out. You, Mark, led us astray.
Oh, that's so harsh.
Yeah, it's not that. So you've got to say Skulk. Anyway, you know when Scott was talking about this sort of evolution of professional rugby and like how now the bottom line's so important and that sort of recreational side of getting gooey's gone? Maybe, yeah. I think it's happening. It's happening because the tune used to be one of the great away trips and now I'd never stay up there, which is fair enough. I suppose it is what it is, but yeah.
Well, you know what you need to do? You need to get back on the commercial flights because guess what? There's no flights out at fucking 10 o'clock at night, is it? So actually, there's me moaning. I wouldn't have got my little trip down to Wine Street had we chartered. So,
yeah, that's a good point.
What's Kyle been saying about, you probably would have seen the he was picked up on the ref mic saying to Adam Brockelbank and there was a bit of sort of back and forth, yeah. And he went, I don't even know who you are, which is quite a good put down contextually. Has he mentioned that at all?
No, I haven't actually spoken to him about that because I only saw it recently on the sort of social media. I was like, fair play, God, I missed that. But Brocklebank's quite game. He loves the chat, loves the chin wag in the game. He's quite a funny dude. Very genial, but yeah, he's always lively. Loves a sledge, loves a bit.
I don't know about that line. I don't like that one. I think it's too easy. It's just I don't even know who you are. Oh, come on, if give me that one. Oh, come on, mate. That's you got something better than that in the back.
I remember playing. I've been done with that by who would I get done with that? Conrad Smith. So he got yellowed when we were playing the Canes, and. I was like this, flapping him off, like, yeah, well done. He saw me and he went full red on me. And I was just like, oh, that was a bite, big fella. And then subsequently, I saw him at my mate's wedding. Oh, it was so funny. So we got to reminisce about that. It was great crack. Lovely bloke. But it was raging. And who else has done it? Another guy I saw do it was Francois Stain to a guy, Mitch Inman, very good centre. And he was giving it the big ones to Francois Stain. And Francois Stain, I don't even know who you are, eh? Two World Cups. And it was jokes. And then Mitchie's just there like, oh. And then all the boys looked at Mitch. He's quiet. And we're just like, oh, no. He's been absolutely done there.
But nothing it's when people bite on it, like you say, Conrad Smith, when he bit on that, And yeah, there's nothing worse than someone goes, oh, got you, you bit him. And
I was like this. Ooh,
oh, God. Because you know, oh, I've bitten. I shouldn't have bitten.
But yeah. But also he's like, who are you, mate? And I'm just like.
he was being honest.
But he's saying it with rage. I'm like, yeah, fair. You're a goat. You are a goat. So it's fine.
Yeah.
Right. What's the best one where you've either heard it or the one that you've bitten?
I've told you, I don't really bite. I don't bite. I'm good at not biting. I'm good at just smiling.
Yeah, I feel just, like you could smile, yeah.
Yeah, very good at smiling. I don't know, yeah, I can't really think of any that have come off, but I just know that that was a horrible one. That's a horrible one. I don't like that one.
Well, because it's simple or because it's mean?
No, just because it's just, I think it's just too easy. It's too easy, and you're like, well, if you had done your research and done a little bit of analysis, you should definitely know who I am. You know, you're not doing enough analysis. I'm gonna have a word with Pat after this. That's what you should have said. And also, yeah. I heard that Sinclair didn't have the best game either. So,
it was not the best time to do it, I suppose. Yeah.
Yeah, that's the other one. You can't go front out there when you're dropping the ball and whatnot.
Yes.
Max doesn't want to comment, but.
Yeah, it's difficult. Yeah. Yeah. You know what I mean? Yeah.
No, I know what I mean. I'm with you.
Have you bitten, Maxi?
Have I bitten on anything bad?
I don't think you, for such a big, giant human being, I think you're too nice, Max. I can't see you getting angry either on the field. I don't know why.
I don't get too angry. No, there's nothing. I've never really.
I can imagine that annoys Pat a bit. I bet he's like, Max, you fucking look at the size of you, mate. Why are you getting angry? Speaking Australian.
Brian Smith did that exact thing. You fucking King Kong, mate.
Yeah. But I could see coaches being like, come on, get angry. What makes you tick? What gets you angry? Like someone not putting their weights away.
I can channel it enough. It's more like, who held me last time? Now it's more outcome driven. It's not really things that people say. So like, if I got dicked and then like someone says something after that, then yeah, do you know what I mean? But if someone just said something out of the blue, it wouldn't really bother me, do you know what I mean?
Yeah, you know the funny thing is as well with props is I think it's the people on their own team that piss them off more than the opposition. It's of our props would come back and we're like, and like if a back row gives a little bit of advice, you know, just you fucking what? Oh mate, lose red. I tell you one night, Dan Lydia straight away, first mall week, I know him quite well. And we're at the bottom of the mall together. I'm fingers in his mouth, like poking him down his throat. He's like, get off. And then I've got his head and I'm rubbing it down below. And he's grabbing hold of my nuts. And I was thinking, if they look back at this and like the TMO, me shoving my finger in his mouth and rubbing his head down below, and then him grabbing hold of my nuts, I reckon both of us would have got like yellow carded.
That is the fun thing, isn't it? With when you're like good mates with people you're playing, you just get weird like that.
And like both just giggling at the bottom of a rack. Like they would have gone absolutely mental at us. But I think, imagine that. Imagine someone hears this, site commissioner goes back out and then cites us both for it. Nut grabbing and mouth poking. Fish hooking. Yeah. That was one.
Have you ever had to explain to a ref that it's okay, we're friends?
Yeah, I have. Yeah. Couple of times, John Barkley all the time, every time, like fingers up bums the lot.
That's an finger, oil
up, finger up the nostril as far as I could as well. I got him.
That's not even fun. That's actually painful.
Yeah, and ran my finger straight up his nostril. What was the other one? Who was the other one? Hamish Watson. We got into a little bit of a fracas, maybe, and we're good, very good mates. But I caught him moaning to the ref afterwards about it, and I was like, "Hold on a minute." So yeah, they're two of them. It happens all the time.